Hello, welcome to module number 2 of Virtual Slide Scanner software demo. In this module, we'll be covering the fluorescence imaging aspect of this microscope. In order to do that, first of all, we have to switch on the right components. So the sequence is following. Number 1 is the main microscope. Number 2 would be this camera. Number 3 would be this brain of the microscope, and number 4 would be the light source, which is a LED light source, and also the CPU, of course. And in order to switch on the camera here, there is a button on the top. You can see it here. There's a sliding button, so you make sure that you switch it on towards the on side, okay? And also make sure that you don't move the camera too much because it is mounted onto this C-mount. Good. So once you have switched on all the components, then you are all set to start the software. So once you have started the software, click on this button highlighted here, the fluorescence button. If you are doing one slide, for the sake of this tutorial, we will be covering only the single slide mode. Whatever we did just for the bright field batch scan will be the same thing which will be applicable for fluorescence batch. So let's focus on fluorescence imaging. If you do click on this button, then it will again ask for automatic load or manual load. Let's do automatic load. Usually this space will be blank. I have this thing here shown because I tried some imaging before. So if you click automatic imaging, then it will again ask you for loading the slides. You click OK, and after that you'll be asked to fill in the details about the slides, and you select the saving location and everything, and you can put in the names and everything, and then you click next. After this, it will ask you what kind of overview would you like to do. If you are doing some kind of cell-based imaging, then you are recommended to use this option, because that will have object detection mode selective for the cells. If you are doing tissue, then you can do the tissue. If you want to do bright field, you can do bright field. There's so many options. And overview can also be done at 2x or 10x. I would recommend doing at 2x because that will save a lot of time for you. And here, using click on this button here, you can get a drop down menu on which channel would you like to get the overview of. For example, this overview was done in DAPI channel. You can also do in the FITC channel or TITC or any other channel. After this, you click overview, and even before that you can also do live. So in order to do that, you click here, and then it will, using this exposure time, you can get a overview image. You can actually select which area would you like to focus upon to get this overview picture. And if you see that exposure is good enough, I see that the amount of light that is coming in is very little, but that should be good enough for overview. As I go to higher magnification, I can actually get a better signal. So if everything is fine, then just stop live, and then you can go for overview. And here is one more important parameter. So if you want to get this dialog box, you click more options while pressing the shift button on the keyboard. If you do this, then it will give you an option in the expert mode where you can select whether you want to switch between the channels before moving XY. This is good if you are doing co-localization, but it will take a lot of time to image. But the microscope stage is actually decent enough that it doesn't give you too much of shifts between the two channels if you are doing one channel at a time. So I would recommend going for move XY before switching the channel. That will save you a lot of time, as well as good for the health of microscope. Okay, so make sure that you have this and click OK. And now you can, once your overview is done, this is how it will look like. I did a overview in FITC channel, and I can see tiny cells here lying all around here. And now I can actually go ahead and do a zoomed in image of this area. So if I use the scroll button, not a scroll button but the scroll wheel, I can zoom in just like you zoom into the Google Maps. You can actually see these cells here. And if you want to get a better quality image of this area, you can select the magnification that you want to use to image and the kind of Z-scan mode that you want to do and click next. After this, you can edit the scan area using this button, just like we did for the bright field. You can draw boxes, you can do area selection and things like that. For this one, I would go for just brute force method because that's not a very big area. Edit focus map. I have added enough focus points and I can see that there are like roughly about 10-12 focal points. So that's not a lot, but that's good enough. I click this next option and now it will ask which all channels do you want to image in. So I have for this example taken DAPI and FITSI. If you want to add more, you can click on this button and then you can add more. And if you want to reorder the positions, you can do this. That doesn't matter much, but yeah, it's always good idea to image the most red color first and then the bluer, because that will avoid photo damage. So after the and how do we select the exposure time? So again, you can start live and see how the intensities are. For example, here if I click start live, then I start seeing the cells in a better resolution and you can see that there is kind of good enough signal. But if you are not happy with the signal, you can notch up the exposure time, but for the sake of this example, I'll be keeping at 300 milliseconds. And same way for DAPI, I have also done. And you can actually navigate on the stage by clicking here anywhere very quickly. So that way, the navigation on stage is very fast. You don't need to always use the joystick. After this is done, now it will ask what kind of focusing would you like to do. So you can do autofocus. Because I had very less number of focal points in this image, so like about 10 to 12 of those, so I will for now use a manual focusing. And if I say check this option and click next, then this kind of a window will open where I can use my Z control to actually find the right focal plane and click next, or I can do autofocus and it will also use the autofocus logic. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work, so that's why I did manual. Once you have done for all the points, then you can click scan now. After the scan now button is clicked, it will start doing XY scans and stitch all the images together. And I captured this image while it was acquired. You can see that the green has been done almost till here and DAPI has already been done. And you can see the rough amount of time it will take. But I don't rely upon this number because it is a lot of times misleading. So if you want to calculate how much time it is going to take for your batch, you do it for one slide and then multiply it for all. You don't depend upon this number. Okay. So after the imaging is done, you can see if you zoom in, you can compare the 2x versus 40x. Yet you can see really nice patterns here, which was not you couldn't have a result at 2x. So after the imaging is done, just like Brightfield, you can add more scans if you are not happy. If you want to image another area, you can add scan, or you can save and continue to the next slide, or you can save and finish. And I would highly recommend saving the project, which we'll talk about at the last part. But before, let's see how we can save this image. So either you can export the file and save as a TIFF or JPEG, but that is going to be a very large file size and it's not practical to use that file for presentations. So that's why we have another option. On the soft computer, there is a snipping tool which you can use. You select this option and then move the image in such a way that the scale bar is in very close proximity to what you want to capture. And once you are ready, you click this and then you drag and select the area, and as soon as it is done, it will automatically crop the image and the image is ready. If you don't want the DAPI, you can switch off using this button. If you don't want FITSI, you can switch off using this. If you want to adjust the brightness, you can select one at a time and then adjust the brightness in the software itself. So, and regarding the file which has been saved, so wherever you have selected, it will automatically be saved. Here is the file and here are the data for it. So make sure that you don't rename the file just like that, because if you rename, then it won't have the address to its data. So if you want to rename any file, then use the software to rename it, or you manually rename both the files in the same way. And also when you copy, just don't copy this one, you have to copy the entire thing. Okay, so here are three images and three corresponding files for it, and I have saved it in a F drive. When you want to finally take the data, you can put it in the interdepartmental RCF users and the your net ID. And with that, we have come to the end of the module, and yeah, this is where you can actually save the project. So if you click this, then you can save the file name. I have used BPAE cells because these were the cells that I used for imaging, and I can save it for my future needs. And I can also use it for use this project for doing batch scan like we did for the bright field imaging. So with that, we come to the end of the module number 2, and happy imaging.